yesterday, but it was long ago. Jane, it was lovely, she was the queen of my night. There in the darkness with the radio playing low, and the secrets that we share, the mountains that we move, caught like a wildfire out of control, till there was nothing left to burn and nothing left to prove. And I remember what she said to me, how she swore. Against the wind, we were young and strong, we were running against the wind. And the years rolled slowly past, and I found myself alone, surrounded by strangers I thought were my friends. Found myself further and further from my home, and I guess I lost my way. There were oh so many roads. I was living to run and running to live, never worried about paying or even how much I owe. Moving 8 miles a minute for months at a time, breaking all myself, searching for shelter again and again, against the wind, little something against the wind. I found myself seeking shelter against the wind.
Against the wind. I got here. Asked my waitress the first morning I was in Winnipeg.
Are you finished with your oatmeal?
Is there someplace nearby where I can
drink your milk?
To buy some orders to get it? And they said, boy, you wouldn't want to do that.
Why not?
I said, why not? She said, well, you know, Winnipeg.
Oh, we're on. You're not going to go sell that on eBay, are you?
You too.
You know what? I can give you some stories to put with that picture that you could probably sell.
Oh, well.
24 hours widow. 2 year old. I just stayed.
Day
stayed. I've been there since.
Wow.
But I got there because of the training program.
He was a baby.
I've been happily married for 44 years. I have the most beautiful gal in the world that can put up with me in Phoenix. Cindy said, I won't know anyone, so I'm not. She's kind of the shy type. And so she said, I won't, and you know I'm not shy. And she says, I won't know anyone. And so I'm just going to stay there. And we have 6 grandchildren, and she absolutely loves. These grandchildren we get, I become, you know, I'm number 8 or number 7 down the line. And so, yes, Sophie.
Charlie, one of the students,
for homecoming.
Oh,
it was almost empty, sad. Remember? It was almost empty.
We used to have a band. We had a band that was big.
Oh, yeah. About, I would say, what, 3 or 4 times as big? Oh, it's 1 week.
Get up the stairs.
All right, where are you then? Get up there.
I don't know who you are, but right there.
Best.
All right, look this way, guys. 1 o'clock.
No,
Judy.
So I can harass you.
Judy, are you going to send us the pictures?
Surveillance?
They're nice.
What is a smart?
There are different in every room that I work in. They computer that's connected to the back.
Are you kidding? Hey, Charles. Okay. So when you got married, were you still in the military?
Yeah.
Sure. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
He was an intern.
Oh, okay.
And then this tall football basketball player next to
you. You knew the weight, didn't you, Sudie? We know Sudie.
Anyway. Yeah.
Sudie says, I'm going to wait a while until the money comes in. Yeah, she called me. I wasn't going to tell you this. She called me and said, I met a pretty good guy here. I'm going to wait until he starts making money.
Sweaty boys are sweaty boys.
So who won the game yesterday?
We did, 17-12. Yeah, 17-12.
Are you done?
Hey, Coach.
Bernie, Coach, hey, good win last night.
Thank you very much.
Coach did a great job. Very good win last night.
Yes, it was. It was huge. That was big. That was big.
That was a nice call by the ref on the tip ball in the shot.
Yeah.
Yes, it was.
I should talk him into it.
Yeah.
Coach, I have a question. In 1967, Burges won its first district title. Has there been any more district titles?
Do you remember watching the pension?
Yes.
Oh, did you?
And then Dennis
Mrs. Robinson, Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray.
Burges in bloom evening where they all had their little gowns on and everything. That picture was taken right there. And then on graduation night, we were all in chairs here. We had to walk up on the stage and get our diploma. And then we walked out that door.
You had graduation here in the gym?
Yep. Yeah, we had to go up on the stage, get our diploma, and then we walked out the store. I just ran across the photograph the other day of us coming out cap and gown. Did you graduate here too?
No.
This was here when I was here. So it was awarded the year before I started here.
Otherwise, you couldn't stand it. Oh, yes. You're back on the seat, are you?
No, I am. After I eat, I got a set of burgers.
I live in Minnesota.
I'll be in there shortly. Thank you.
State your name and purpose.
Oh, okay. Jeannie Harrell. Used to be Jeannie Beth Poe.
You are going
to
believe me.
Yeah, we'll see. I believe everything.
Tickets here for raffle tickets, so if you haven't bought any, it's very important. We're going to raffle off this beautiful painting by formerly, we knew her as Laura Stong in high school, very prominent Santa Fe artist, McCreary Jordan, donated this painting. And thank you for that. The funds will be used to cover the cost of a lot of the expenses that the ladies incur to get the t-shirts and to get the room, and there are a lot of expenses. Anything that's left over, Laura's been kind enough to say that we can donate it to something at Burges High School, you know, from the class of 65. So that it's a good cause. So, you know, buy tickets, five for $20. Or if we don't sell enough of the t-shirts, we encourage you to buy a t-shirt. Even if, you know, you just wear it to mow the lawn. Does anybody mow the lawn? I do. I was a yard boy and it just never went away. But I do want to thank everybody for making the effort to come. And once again, I can't tell you because how much I appreciate Judy and Judy for all the work they've done. A lot of us here were military and moved away. Those that moved away, we just lost contact with.
Here we go, John Cracker.
They must have had that emergency 9, right?
Now, I don't know why John showed up late. He's normally, you remember, the track star. He was always first.
Running in the wrong direction.
Buy some tickets.
He's going to be the keeper of the flag in memory of his brother, Raul, and all of those that have fallen in, not just Vietnam, but we've had several different incidents. And presenting to him to keep it.
Thank you very much.
A lot of you remember Raul. We called him Junior. He's one of my favorite people at Burges. The last time I saw him, I think did he work at Gunning Cash Deal?
Walgreens.
And I saw him and we talked and he was telling me that he was going into the service and that's the last time I saw him and he was wonderful. And so on behalf of Raul,
I appreciate it.
First of all, I want to thank you all for inviting me. Okay? It's been fun watching the people. I was a freshman when you were all seniors. And I used to admire the ladies, and I used to be in.
So did I!
I was beautiful women, and you were ladies. And all the guys seemed to be very smart, very athletic.
Still are.
Football players and such. But I want to say this. One of the TV series that came out was in 66 was Star Trek. And y'all remember Dr. Spock, right? And he said, live long and prosper. Well, you have. And I thank you very much.
Everybody that we know of is listed, and it's in the Facebook group as R period, I period, P period. Classmates and signed teachers, Burges High School. And what I did was I first developed it because I had my dad being a teacher, also at Andrus. Under the cover picture, there's a file. It's a very last section. And you can open up files and you will find by class, most of the classes are listed by memorial list of classmates by their specific class.
Marine Corps.
Semper Fi.
Choke a Marine.
Well, we all kind of did, you know?
Reading when I was in the service, and I read a lot. When I got out, I was able to do the SATs. I went from 299 to.
Gail had her seat was holding up, and she was fine.
It's reportedly a Merlot, but I can't be sure so far. Yeah.
Well, you know, like in our group, okay,
I can't help it.
When did you get so strong?
When I went through the snake bite thing. Well,
I'm gonna sit down for a minute.
Okay.
Go ahead.
They recorded it on Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Yeah.
And then Telemundo.
And so that's how we
back. My youngest daughter has nicknamed me Bobcat, and I plan on writing a book soon called God's Bobcat, and I'll detail the four times I had a brush with life, with death rather, and here I am again. So as far as I'm concerned, I've got five more chances.
Good for you.
So it was it's been a very interesting deal. So
what do you remember? I don't remember
much from 2013 and 14. I don't remember. My daughters graduated from high school in 2014. I don't remember.
Is this going to be on MTV later?
Maybe.
30, that's really good. It was Marriott, wasn't it? Marriott.
Show you the man.